Uganda Police Forces, Uganda Police and Uganda Prisons Forces have gone to Rwanda to participate in a joint training for East African Security Forces, codenamed Ushirikiano Imara, in a bid to promote peace, security and stability towards the East African community integration. In this 13th edition, Uganda joins other East African countries including Rwanda, Kenya, Tanzania, Burundi, DRC and South Sudan. Brigadier General Fred Twinamasco, who was leading the delegation, said the forces shall be training in tactical warfare and counter-terrorism training.
The aim is to enhance our partner states' defense forces' capabilities in jointly combating complex security challenges in the region.
Brigadier General Alex Olupot, in charge of training in the UPDF, said this joint exercise is aimed at strengthening the East African integration.
Promotion and fostering of the East African integration. We also geared towards enhancing interoperability in joint planning and also in the conduct of operations.
Major General Francis Takira, the Deputy Infantry Commander, emphasized discipline among the members of the security forces who are going to take part in this joint exercise. He emphasized the purpose for this training.
Baba President Bafichiva Uchebakola Barwanirida Obumu wa East Africa.
The Minister of Trade has handed the newly constructed warehouse in Masafu Town Council to an investor who shall help in adding value on agriculture products worth exportation. John Mulimba, the State Minister for Foreign Affairs, on behalf of the Minister of Trade, said the Ministry of Trade has handed the investor the facility that has been lying idle since completion of its construction. He appealed to farmers and produce dealers to embrace the project and supply the investors with the products.
Committed to Ugandans to grow wealth, to grow the GDP of Uganda through industrialization and mainly targeting value addition of agriculture resources.
Dr. Thelima Awori, the director of Masafu Industries, said they're going to have produce that can compete on the international markets. Michael Chiwika, the CRDC, said that initially there were some issues of land disputes that have been fully settled, and now the project has been given a green light.
I am optimistic that we are meant to have started some time back, but because of a few differences which could have been technical and political in nature, we have not been able to commence operations of this facility.
Equipment next week, that's why we've been pressurizing the local authorities, the Ministry of Trade, and finally the Minister for Regional Cooperation. We've been pressurizing everybody to give us permission to come and start our work here.
Mangeni Samokomu, the Masafu Town Council Mayor, lauded the Minister of Trade for considering to operationalize the warehouse facility because it had become a hideout for criminals.
We have also heard that some of the thefts that take place around the merchandise is sometimes stored here, or people planning to go and steal, sit here and plan to go and carry out those bad activities.
The over 18 billion shillings project was handed over to an investor who is partnering with African Power Initiative, who shall utilize the facility for the undisclosed period of time. A hospital in Gaza said Thursday the death toll from an Israel airstrike on a UN school, which the military said housed a Hamas compound, had risen to 37. The Al-Aqsa Martyrs Hospital said it had received 37 martyrs from the strike on the UN school, updating an earlier figure of 27 given the Hamas media office. The Israel Army said a fighter jet conducted a precise strike on the Hamas compound embedded inside the school in the area of Nuseirat in central Gaza. UNRWA is the UN agency supporting Palestinian refugees. A medic at the hospital said another Israel strike during the night on the house in Nuseirat refugee camp killed 6 people and wounded several more.